imagine this. Every child in your classroom writing either on or above grade level. Hi, I'm Mike Devano, and today I'm going to show you how to teach your children how to write with spice. Period. For anything. You see, I don't teach to a test. I teach through the test to the other side. So when the children are finished a year, they remember how to write for life. And that is my goal. But remember, one way first. Don't overload your children. If you overload them, they're not going to know what to do. One skill at once. These are all the coordinated conjunctions that make a compound sentence. Comma for, comma in, comma nor, comma but, comma or, comma yet, and comma so. And these work very well. They've just put this little acronym up there and check them off. Dude, this is the point of life where I ask my children to start saying punctuation. Why? It's a great way to proofread, and they don't even know they're proofreading. And it works. You'll see it work phenomenally. Because if you don't say the period, they'll call it out for you. They'll correct you, and it sounds something like this. I like cake, comma, and I like pie, period. Now, I'm not going to teach my kids semicolon. I'm going to teach them a conjunctional adverb that does take a semicolon, okay? For the simple fact that this is how they work. Now, semicolon, however, comma means comma, but. And it sounds like this. I like school, comma, but my teacher gives me too much homework, period. I like school, semicolon, however, comma, my teacher gives me way too much homework, period. What we have to do is when you do teach figurative language, we can use three different ways to teach it. We can say something is that, something is almost that, or something is not that. Just remember, because after this, I want you to get into things called descriptive details or imagery. And that's the next step to figurative language. All right, it sounds something like this. His eyes filled with misty water as his tears slowly dripped onto his cheeks and plopped onto the floor. Period. What's he doing? He's crying. And what do you do since I'm going to compare and contrast? I circle what I feel is the same. And I put little boxes around what I think is different. So when the kids go back, there's your compare and contrast. Now I'm going to spice up my paper a little bit of this and a little bit of that. So what I want is I want to indent. So I go check, indent. I want a beginning. I go check. See, your children are going to remember you forever and ever. But if they remember one thing about you, let it be that when somebody walks up to them and says, hey, who taught you how to write? Let it be your name that crosses their lips. Period.